Well, good morning, good afternoon, everybody. My name is Joe Morse. That was a great session by Kathy and team last time. Thank you. I'll be presenting without the camera today, guys. Great session by Kathy and team prior. CMS is a great subject, and it kind of leads into what we're talking about today. My name is Joe Morse. I work with Experience Cloud, which is Salesforce's way of standing up digital properties. We're going to be talking about simplifying experience user administration with Flow. So let's get started on the content today. Let's take this over to a quick agenda. We'll start by talking about trends in automation and experience user administration. We'll talk a little bit about the package that we have today, experience user utilities, and we'll see it. And then at the end, we've got some learning resources and ideas for you. Let's talk a little bit about trends in automation. Now, you heard the folks at the beginning of the session cover these, but it makes sense to reiterate a couple of them and relate them to the world that we live in with Experience Cloud. You saw that the digital imperative is moving everyone forward. Everyone wants automation. We want to make things easier and faster and simpler for customers and employees. But one critical aspect of that is that most executives believe that the employee experience drives the customer experience. So if we're automating things, making things easier for employees, we can make things better for the customer. We can also make it better for customers directly. Now, we who work with Experience Cloud know this innately. We know that disconnected experiences, digital properties, moments of engagement through your contact center, and moments of purchase can really harm your brand if you don't get them right. That's why we built Experience Cloud. Experience Cloud, simply put, is Salesforce's web platform. Our customers use it to build digital properties of many different types: commerce storefronts, self-service sites, big, heavy portals to engage their partners and customers and others. It's about 10 years old. We've been doing this a long time, and Flow plays a critical part for that. Now, this isn't a session on Experience Cloud, but one little quirk we have with Experience Cloud is that we connect every user to a CRM record. Every user is connected to the contact in Salesforce. But in order to administer the user, you have to get out of Lightning Experience and get into setup to see the user and do common tasks on it. That can be very disruptive when we do administration on the contact record and it doesn't end there. Getting out and losing that portion of the experience can be problematic. Now, at the same time, a lot of Experience Cloud customers have really sophisticated needs to do things with their Experience Cloud users, not just simple password resets or user creation or freezing of users, but many customers use very sophisticated permission sets groups. They update related data when they're administering users. The need for automation in user administration is very, very high, especially when you're doing it at customer scale. And so we thought, how am I going to manage all of this complexity and make it simpler for my folks internally? At the same time, as you saw, Flow is getting better and better and better over the years. It's a key tool that Salesforce has been investing in, both for employee-facing workflows and customer-facing workflows, and even headless workflows. So that gave us an idea. Maybe we could use Flows to keep folks in the console as they do administrative tasks on Experience Cloud users. It started off as a simple idea, and it developed into a free starting point called the Experience User Utilities. Now, these are out there for free on the AppExchange. They are open source, and they're for you. So let's take a quick look at those Experience User Utilities. We're going to take a look at the utilities themselves, the starting points that we give you. Then we're also going to take a look behind the scenes, see how some of the flows are made. So let's flip over to this other screen here and take a look. Here I am, right within the Service Cloud console. I may be in here as an agent taking customer cases. And if I happen to come across a case that says a customer can't log into the customer portal, they've tried 70 times, I might want to take a look at their contact record. And this kind of starts our journey here. So if I open the contact record in the console, the first thing you're going to see is a quick glimpse of things. You have all of your normal contact details and the fields and everything on the right there. But over here on the left, there are a couple of components here that give me some information about the Experience Cloud user. I've got her name and email address. I've got a quick note here that the password is locked because she's tried to log in too many times and wasn't successful, as well as some other basic information about the last time she's logged in, the password has when it was last reset, number of failed login attempts, and other key data. This here is a flow. This is one of the elements of the package that puts the user details right on the contact record and helps us get into some of the pieces that we need to do. Now, we need to take action. Normally, from here, I would click into setup and use one of my buttons to view the experience, or view the customer user, edit the user, change the password, or unfreeze and do common tasks. But since we have the power of flow at our disposal, we have some very quick and easy buttons up here. I've got this freeze and unfreeze user button right up here on the contact record. And when I click it, it's going to invoke another flow. And this flow simply allows me to freeze or unfreeze a particular user so that they can't log in anymore. And we can do this a variety of times. We can freeze, we can unfreeze, and we can take care of things so that user is allowed to log in. Now, this could be accompanied by an automated email if you wanted to put that in the flow. It could be accompanied by a lot of different automations under the hood. Now, sometimes the user just needs their password reset. So the second flow that we have is one that resets a password. And if I click that one, it's going to bring up confirmation and say, hey, we're going to reset the password and send an email to this user because they've been trying to log in and they can't get in. And clicking through on the flow does a bunch of things in the background. It resets the user password. It sends them an automated email that says, welcome to our new Experience Cloud site. Go ahead and reset your password at this link. And we've done this all without leaving the contact record. Now, the final one that I'm going to use today is this one here, and it's a big long one. It's called Disable, Deactivate, and Reactivate an External User. For Experience Cloud, we have many different ways of turning a user on and off, and I won't get into the details of it, but broadly, you can deactivate them temporarily, you can disable the user permanently, and if you deactivate them, you can reactivate. And so if for some reason we found out that Barbara was on a leave of absence from her company and we needed to prevent her from logging into the portal during that time, we can very easily deactivate this person and temporarily deactivate them. And now that user record has been marked as deactivated and Barbara can no longer log in. So very, very easy administration, very, very easy changes of things. But let's actually take a look at how some of these things are built behind the scenes. Our goal in building these items was to make them completely declarative. And so if I jump into Salesforce setup here, you'll see this package comes with several flows, including a couple of utility flows. We'll take the most complex one that we have here, this disable, deactivate, and reactivate external user. And you can see that it's using good practices here. It's making use of subflows, it's branching and making decisions, determining whether people are active or inactive, and then from there, presenting screens that allow people to disable and re-enable or do various administrative tasks on the user. We also have little warnings put in text here that are whose visibility is set conditionally. So if the user is frozen because they tried to log in too many times, we'll display this message. If the password was locked because for whatever reason, then we'll display this message. There's a ton of things that we can do just with regular native flow features and without getting crazy on the extensibility of things. We've also tried to use text templates to display formatted text commonly across screens, like we're showing the user details here as well. And we've tried to make minimal use of custom Lightning componentry just to keep the level of complexity down and to keep the package maintainable for folks. But this one actually shows the profile image and email of the current user related to this. Now, you can see there is a lot of branching. There's a lot of use of subflows here to actually perform the administrative tasks. And there are quite a bit of kind of component reuse as well as good management of the way these flow paths goes on the screen. And you can take a look at some of these things if you install this package in your org and get to it. By the way, this package also works for person accounts. So we're not going to leave that out. So in summary, we've got a nice starting point package for you to use, two of them actually. And we've put the code bits of this in an open source thing, as you'll see. But let's talk about a few lessons that we learned. We know that writing code is powerful, and it's some people's default language, myself included. But code can be inflexible. And so over my career at Salesforce, I've found that if you can call your code from a declarative tool like Flow, it makes it powerful and flexible. Use Flow as that wrapper for the heavily custom stuff that you do. Now, Flow can take a lot of what used to be programmatic, a lot of the logic like looking up data, making decisions and other things, and make it point and click, declarative. But you can't always do everything with Flow. So take a design mentality and a maintenance mentality to your flows. Now, with Experience Cloud, the user and contact relationship is very, very powerful. We use it within Experience Cloud audiences and other places. And we can also use it within this package and use it to your advantage and to support your 360-degree view of your customer. Now, as you saw at the beginning of today, making your flows robust, handling errors, using fault paths, anticipating problems and misuse of your tool is key to success in Flow. And there's a great set of resources out there that we'll just talk about in a few moments. First things first, there's an extension package. This is actually two packages for the price of one. We have our base package, which supports the contact and B2B accounts. We also have a person account package. So if you're using person accounts in your org, install both packages and you should be ready to go. We've put out all of our source code for some of those pieces where we're writing a custom component or we have an Apex utility that we absolutely need to do things. We have a GitHub repository out there for experience user utilities. So grab the source code there if you need be, follow the project and go from there if you really want to get into the code angle of this. Finally, there's some critical resources for both Experience Cloud and Flow. LearnExperienceCloud.com is a great way to get started with Experience Cloud. It contains blog content on the product, as well as events and other resources. Unofficial Salesforce is another fantastic resource where it lists Flow, Next Best Action, and Orchestrator extensions that are unofficial, but really work well and serve as great extension points and UI pieces there. Finally, we do workshops with Experience Cloud, so you can see some of this in action every 2 weeks or so. We try to do 90-minute hands-on introduction to Experience Cloud, and we use flows as a critical part of these workshops. There are other resources for you as well. Plenty on Experience Cloud and Flow out there on Trailhead, as well as the Trailblazer community. You can get started with Experience Cloud and Flow in your sandboxes. We're hoping you use it to get started today and grab our packages that we're talking about today to go to work. Now, finally, I think I'm a little early today, but I'm really looking forward to the next session. My old friend David Chack is going to take us through Invocable Apex and talk about very powerful programmatic logic coming from Flows. That's it for me. Thank you to everyone.